In the next 10 minutes, we will look at the process to register Azure Stack as well as market for multi-tenancy, onboard a new customer, tag it to the appropriate CSP tenant, and then offboard that tenant. The process to deploy Azure Stack involves multiple steps. During the deployment and configuration, there are a number of important milestones, the first one being selecting the identity provider together with the other prerequisites which are asked by the hardware vendor. The identity provider is the actual AAD which will be used to authenticate in the admin portal. This is very important and cannot be changed without actually redeploying the entire stack. Once all the deployment prerequisites are identified, the hardware partner will continue with the deployment itself. This is completely driven by the hardware partner themselves, and at the end of it, you will have a working, functioning Azure Stack deployment, which will then require registration. The registration enables marketplace syndication and usage reporting. For registering your Azure Stack, you will need an Azure subscription, which in the case of a CSP, it will be the shared services or internal usage rights subscription. The shared services subscriptions are the preferred choice for registration, but there are some exceptions. One thing to note is that the shared services subscriptions are associated with a shared tenant, a shared services tenant. This tenant is different than the AAD you've used to actually register Azure Stack. The two do not have a common AAD, and they're not the same directory. So this is perfectly okay, and there's no issue whatsoever to using a different tenant from the one you've used for your identity provider. Once the registration is complete, you will now be able to onboard new tenants on Azure Stack itself. Here you can see a new deployment of Azure Stack where the registration piece was not done yet. So if we go into the marketplace management, you'll see that we will be prompted with a message saying we need to register first. The registration is triggered using an owner of that subscription. So in my case here, I'm using the admin at AZ Stack Reseller 1, which is an owner of that subscription. It only has one subscription in that directory, so I don't need to select it. I'll just go ahead and first register the resource provider and then trigger the actual registration piece using the Azure Stack tools. Once the required modules are imported, the registration is kicked off and the process will go on and register your Azure Stack deployment to the respective Azure subscription. Once the registration is complete, you will have access to the marketplace syndication and usage reports will be sent to the Azure Commerce server. So in the case of the CSP, the partner center itself will display that usage. If you would also stop here and not enable multi-tenancy, the entire usage will be reported against the initial subscription you've used for the registration. So in the CSP case, if you've used the shared services, the entire usage reports will fall under that shared services subscription. Once the registration is complete, you can go back to the marketplace management, refresh the portal, and you will see the Add from Azure option, which will give you access to all the images available on the Azure site. So if you click here Windows Server 2016, you'll be able to download the image and kickstart the process to make it available on the Azure Stack site. To enable multi-tenancy on the Azure Stack side, you actually need to go through a two-step process. The first one will configure the Azure Stack directory, and the second one will configure the guest directory. In my case, Azure Stack Reseller 1 is my Azure Stack directory. This is the one I'm using to actually log in Azure Stack on the management side, and it's the one I've used to as an identity provider for Azure Stack. My guest directory in this case will be Azure Stack Test 1. This corresponds to a CSP tenant. So on the partner center side, I've created a tenant called Azure Stack Test 1. And this is the user, this is the actual tenant I'm using to onboard on the Azure Stack side. So the first step is to configure the Azure Stack directory. And this is a simple register-az-guest-directory-tenant command. And once this is complete, you will need to run the second part, which is the configure guest directory piece. The second part you will run with the admin from the tenant you plan to onboard side. So in this case, it will be an admin at azstack test 1, and this will be used to configure the actual guest directory. So we can run this command now, and we will use the credentials of that admin. It needs to be a global admin in the respective AAD, and that will create all the objects and so on to enable users from that directory to log in Azure Stack. In this case, here you will see a small error which appears because we are logged in now with the tenant of with an admin from the tenant we plan to onboard. So the error, it's a fairly common error. We only need to run a simple command, which is add Azure RM environment. So we need to tell, we need to specify the actual environment we're gonna use. And once this is done, we can rerun the script, use the same global admin we've used from the tenant side, and give it the proper password, and it will go through all the steps required. There's a number of steps it needs to do, and there are some objects it needs to create in the guest directory. Once these are all complete, these users will be able to log in Azure Stack and create new subscriptions. Each of the newly created subscriptions will enable the tenants to create resources and virtual machines and so on, which will in turn generate usage. This usage is being piped at this point to the initial subscription we've used to actually register Azure Stack. So because this is a CSP scenario and a multi-tenancy scenario, right now all the usage is being sent to one subscription. So the next step will be to tag each of these subscriptions and match them to the appropriate CSP tenant. Once the onboarding is complete, we can open a new browser in private and connect to the user portal. Now we will be using an admin from the or any user from the tenant we've just onboarded. That tenant will have access to our Azure Stack and will be able to create a new subscription. Now, this is a newly created Azure Stack, so we don't have any offers and created yet, so that this tenant will not be able to create anything because he's not seeing any offers available. This will be part of another video, and once those offers are created on the admin side, they'll be usable by the tenants onboarded. The product group has published a white paper which describes all the steps required to enable multi-tenancy, tag the appropriate tenants, and match these to their respective CSP tenants. The white paper itself can be found on the EAI portal, and we will link this to the webcast as well. It goes through all the details required, including descriptions of the billing, and then the reasons why you should register your stack, and then details on the initial registration. These are the things we've already talked in our video, but you will find more information here about it. Then we're coming to the step where we're actually registering a tenant. So in the case where we have already onboarded a new tenant on Azure Stack, we have the CSP tenant configured. Now we need to actually get our registration approved to use multi-tenancy. This is the step described here, where we need to prepare an email which looks like this, and it includes the resource ID and the resource group ID, as well as a snapshot of the registration we've done. To pull this information, we will need to go on the Azure side, and here you see my Azure Stack Reseller 1 tenant, and this is my only Azure subscription where I have this registration of my Azure Stack. So all these informations will need to be sorted and added inside an email, send out to this alias, and then this will trigger a multi-tenancy to be enabled, or tagging to be enabled for you. Once this is complete, you will be able to actually run this command and map the respective Azure Stack subscriptions or tenants to the CSP tenants and their respective subscriptions. When this is all complete, what happens is that during the reconciliation of the usage, each CSP tenant will receive their respective usage. So you'll be able to see the usage of each of the tenants inside Partner Center, and then that will flow to your billing solution and so on. Here we are connected to the default provider subscription, and running this partial command, we will get all the onboarded tenants. So as you can see, we have two tenants onboarded, a test one and a test two, and we will go ahead and remove offboard test two. Now, to do this, we will need to start the other way around from the onboarding part. So we will start with actually configuring the tenant directory first. This will remove the installed Azure Stack identity applications and their permissions within the Colors Azure Active Directory tenant. So running this, we will give it the rights to, we will use the global admin from that tenant. So in my case, test two, and this will remove that identity application. Once this is complete, we will run a second command on the Azure Stack side. So this will be configuring permissions on the Azure Stack itself, right? It will remove all the permissions necessary, and it will essentially offboard that tenant. To accomplish this, we will need an owner of the Azure Stack default provider subscription, and once this is complete, that tenant is essentially offboarded. So if a user would go ahead and try to log in, they would get an error page saying that it doesn't work. So if we run the same command to get the tenants which are onboarded, you will see that now we have only AZ Stack test one. So if we were to open a new browser and try to use the tenant which we've offboarded, right? So AZ Stack 2, they would still have the sign in, but once you try to log in, you would actually get an error message which says that the account is not authorized to access the portal because we've offboarded it, right? If we instead would use the AZ stack, let me pull the login. So if we go to a portal using the AZ test one, right? So AZ stack test one, this would still work. The users are still able to log in and to use the portal.